computer che... Two slides that we have presented to the ANFN Scientific Committee. The first slide contains the participants, people that have expressed interest in FCC in general. It's not this one. Okay, it's this one. And I have to warn you that we started discussing a little bit this Italian interest toward FCC in during last summer. And we were maybe 10-ish people or so. And then the scientific committee asked us to present the status in January. And while I was collecting expression of interest, you see, take a look to the font that have become smaller and smaller. To make the story short, this is continuing in these weeks. So there is quite a sizable interest in Italy. These people are about 80. I will not be surprised if in a few months we'll exceed 100. Clearly, you shouldn't imagine these people will work with a sizable amount of time. Will be a small fraction of the time, but I think the quality and the coverage of the expertise is quite large and quite interesting. So you see, there are 10, 15 laboratories interested. Among them, some of the traditionally the most, let's say, established within ANFN. There are a few others that will join. And if I go to the next slide, that is the last one. This slide summarizes the interests. So we are now in a phase in which we are collecting still the interest of the various people. We have decided to organize the work in these four activities, accelerator related activities, physics altogether, E plus E minus, hadrons and heavy ion, detectors and computing. So it's quite a sizable effort. We are going to have a very light organization, really to be the most efficient we can. And we are discussing within INFN what is the best framework in which we can produce this effort. So maybe it will be useful to listen from the INFN management what they think about it.
Thank you for the question. Well, I think that this FCC initiative is strategic for two main reasons. The first one is to develop new technologies for the magnets. I think that if we want to make the next step after LHC, let's say the next run of LHC, and to increase the energy, to increase the phase space where we want to find something new, we need to develop new technology on the magnets and on the acceleration. And this is the first goal that this initiative should address. The second one is concerning the physics case. We have largely discussed it today and it will be discussed in the next days. And as it was pointed out today, the situation is quite confused. And I think that to make this kind of studies is important to understand the different options. And I think we will know for sure something new from the next run. So next LHC run will give some hints if we will find something or nothing or in which direction we want to go. The same, I think, is valid for the magnets. So, for example, I don't know if in the future we will have a future circular collider at CERN, 80, 100 kilometers, or something in China, or some different accelerators. But for sure, or maybe to increase the energy in the present tunnel of LHC. But for sure, we will need some new magnets and some new technology in order to address this topic. So for this reason, I think it's strategic to participate to this initiative. I think also that, as I told you, for the physics, we will know something new in the, we will know something new in the next years. So given this fact, INFN is interested to support this initiative. Of course, is some kind of side initiative, is not our primary goal. And we should handle it in parallel with the main effort, which is the run of LSE and the development of the detector for the upgrades and so on. So in which frame we use it is still under discussion, but for sure we are interested to a participation in this initiative.
Roberto, you want to answer? I can add a couple of comments. The first is about the two meetings we had in Italy, the one of this morning in Pisa, and then we had another one in Frascati, was mid-October. I mean, by purpose, we organized the work of FCCEE and HH as a single package. So the community and the list of people are seen there, and the list which is even incomplete because there are people that we know are interested and signed the famous paper on FCC initial study on TLEP, initial study that for various reasons they didn't attend that meetings, but we know that are interested. So in fact it is of the order of 100 people. And this is organized as a common work in the two accelerators in the semi-tunnel. I think this is important. We plan to continue like that. It gives important synergy and help, since also we know that from the point of view of the software and so we have many tools which are the same. So this will help a lot. The second comment I want to make, in parallel way, as you probably know, it's since more than 1 year that in Italy we are discussing and thinking about the future of our field in a process which is SNOMAS-like, which we call What Next, and there are working groups in this process, and there are at least two which have shown a great interest in FCC, both EE and HH, and these are the standard model group and the beyond the standard model group. This is not a surprise. And these working groups, they are writing their conclusions in a write-up that will appear in some form in a not too far future. And what I can say is that in the discussions and in the work that took place, that there is clearly solid interest. And even by a third group, even the group which is related to flavor of physics, for instance, for Z, flavor of change in neutral kinetic decays, and so on, so that they mentioned the importance of of this project. So clearly the interest is there, and no need to say that as always one of the problems is the time, because many of these people which are very interested are also very busy with the other current activities. So this is one of the main problems, but clearly the support by the community is growing, and I've seen it since 1 year and a half, steadily growing. So it is stronger now than it was 1 year ago. This I think I can say, and being witness of all this discussion in the What Next working groups.
So to make a sort of conclusion, I think the message that we can give to our friends and colleagues of FCC EE community, which is majority here, is that the effort in Italy will continue with additional strength, we hope, and INFN will be supporting this effort, and we have to discuss together responsibility, sharing some of the open issue, and we might be able to give contributions to the common effort. Alan.
I have a question to you. In the kind of efforts you're trying to assemble, you mentioned principally the study of high field magnets. You also mentioned acceleration, so I suppose the superconducting RF and other E plus minus technologies are interest to you. What kind of package do you imagine for the experimental studies? More like detector studies? I think we need first to generate the panorama of the experimental panorama before we do that. But maybe before we are able to do this, we need a few people to look at the experimental panorama. So are you envisaging to get a few positions to do those studies, or how does that work?
If I could go ahead, and this presentation is in Italian, but you might understand, that there is a detailed understanding for each laboratory, take Bari, the first one, of the interest in which you see also there is also detector R&D, the Italian tradition, you know us well.
Yes.
Once we have an idea of performing some measurements in physics, immediately we try to optimize the best tool to do it. And so there will be some R&D detectors. We discussed this morning with the INFM president of Scientific Commission 1, the way in which, if we have a particular detailed R&D project, how can we find some resources to have it running? And we have a proposal to go to Commission 5, which helps in R&D activity. So I think this could fly. But you should give us some time to organize it properly.
I think clearly the detector needs will be made more clear by a little bit of physics studies. They don't need an enormous amount, but...
Correct.
So putting the scope of what we need is important.
Let me stress on one point, continuing what Alain said. What I see is a project that has a very long time scale, but on the other end we have a deadline that is why we have started. So would be a pity if we miss this deadline for what concerns the detector studies, simply because of lack of resources. And this is a problem. Now, we work always in the framework of best effort, and we are not discussing that we need huge resources to build an upgrade of something. What we are discussing is that we need those 30 people that can work on this. Now, how you can help on this is not clear to me. But what is needed now, seen from my observatory, is to have a good bunch of students that could work well for a couple of years on this project to arrive with some benchmark study well done at the time that will be needed. That is in 2 years from now, it's not in 25 years. And I think that we really run the risk that we arrive there with a good study of the accelerator, because this is much more structured, and CERN is putting resources on it, as we have seen from Frank. But we don't have the equivalent study on one side, on the physics programs. On the other side, on the fatibility or not of some theoretical calculation that are needed if we want to exploit these machines. So this is a bit the what I see today. I mean, we have people with ideas, we have people with good willing, we have LHC running, and so it's to find the right equilibrium in all this is difficult, and this is the exact point that I see as a point of failure.
Since we are discussing, I can inject some more confusion on this. I agree with you. I think that this is true on the short time. You mentioned deadline into 2 years. I think we should also think on a more far future. So we are discussing the physics, we are discussing the detector. I think also computing is an important issue. If you take as an example the computing, I think we will not use we cannot use, it is impossible to use the present structure of computing if you want to analyze all the data of FCC. And the same is true for LHC phase two, in my opinion. So I think we should think to new paradigms for computing. I think it would be very welcome to have the same thinking for the detectors. Now we are used to exploit the usual technique we have used for LEP or for LHC on the detector. Maybe it would be very useful also to develop very breakthrough new techniques for detector for this long-term effort.
You open another dimension. I was much more modest. I wanted to find two students
since we are,
with Roberto.
Since we are speaking, I tell you my opinion.
10 to the 12Z. That
is very good.
You know, I dare making a comment or a suggestion to the INFN management. Which seems a contradiction at first, but it is actually not, I think, right? Now, as you remember, I said that I am looking at the LHC 13 or 14 result with great interest, right? But it seems to me, if I were the INFN management, I would not, the focus on what will come from there, right, should not, in my view, orient your prospect for the future. I don't know if that is clear enough. In other words, it's possible that the LHC 14 will not bring any new, but that already now I see it not as a dramatic change of the future of the field, and that I think is the way in which you should look at the future of the field, right? On one side, one can be optimistic. On the other side, the future of the field, to me, already now, is sufficiently clear that one should. Right, one should, but not only in FCC in all directions, right? I mean, because you see, if you charge too many expectation on LHC, then you may cause a wrong attitude with respect to the field in case the LHC will not bring us something, right? And that is possible. There is nobody that can tell you that there is such and such measurement that will give a dramatic change in the situation, right? So I think you should be prepared for that.
Alan.
Yeah, there's one thing I wanted to say earlier, which I didn't, but I think it's missing in the discussion, but you guys are completely in agreement with what I'm going to say. The electron and proton physics conveners are working together to establish a table of complementarity of the two projects, in which you can see that these two machines are extremely complementary in what they can do. There's a number of things about the Higgs that you can do at the electron machine. There's a number of the things about the Higgs that you can only do at the hadron machine. And the same is true for searches for heavy neutrinos, for whatever subject, top mass, top properties, rare decays, etc. Whatever is neutral can be done at the LHC or the FCC HH. Whatever is charged with missing particles can be done with the electron machine, etc. So there's a great deal of complementarity, which we are in the process of documenting and which we hope to be complete by 2018. So I think that's absolutely essential. What we also see is that given the international competition, the first to have a tunnel will win. Okay, so we should really see it this way, because if we wait until whatever until the magnets are ready, for instance, then it's almost certain that the magnets will be put in another tunnel somewhere else. And so I think we have to be a little bit conscious of that aspect, which is nice because it proves that somebody else understands that this physics is important, but which is also a little bit of a threat for us.
Shall we close it here? Yes. I see all of you. Okay, so thanks a lot to everybody. I remind you...